وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
A questioner asked, I've watched some of your videos and they have inspired me to memorize the Qur'an. What steps can I take to help me finish the Qur'an and stay consistent upon my memorization?
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to respond to your question. What I want, inshallah ta'ala, the questioner to understand is memorizing the Qur'an is a communal obligation. It's not an individual obligation. It's called fardu kifaya. And fardu kifaya means إِذَا قَامَ بِهِ بَعْضٍ سَقَطَ عَنِ الْبَاقِينَ. If a group of people stand up to memorize the Qur'an, it is not obligatory on every single Muslim to memorize. And this is a unanimous agreement amongst the scholars. And Ibn Hazm rahimahullah, he transmitted the ijma' in his kitab, Maratib al-Ijma'. And everybody else is highly recommended for them to memorize the Qur'an. That's point number one, inshallah ta'ala. Also, memorizing the Qur'an, there are many virtues that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah azza wa jalla have mentioned for the one who sits down and memorizes the Qur'an. The first virtue, inshallah ta'ala, is that which al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his sahih min hadith Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best amongst you is the one who memorized the Qur'an and teaches it. Also, the second benefit is the person who memorizes the Qur'an is the one who should be put forward in leading the prayer. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith, Al-Imam Muslim narrated in his sahih min hadith Abi Mas'udin al-Ansari al-Badri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet, he said, يَأُمُّ الْقَوْمَ أَقْرَأُهُمْ لِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ أَحْفَظُهُمْ. The person who should lead the people is the one who knows the Qur'an the most. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would place in the grave first in the battle the one who had taken and memorized the Qur'an the most. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would say, أَيُّهُمْ أَكْثَرُ أَخْذًا لِلْقُرْآنِ. Which of these two individuals has memorized the most Qur'an? فَإِذَا أُشِيرَ لَهُ, if someone was mentioned to him, إِلَىٰ أَحَدِهِمَا قَدَّمَهُ فِي اللَّحَدِ, the Prophet would put that person first in the lahad. Al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated this min hadith Jabirin radiyallahu ta'ala anhumah. The third virtue, inshallah ta'ala, is the virtue in the hereafter, in Jannah. The person who memorized the Qur'an, who has taken most of the Qur'an or all of the Qur'an, that person's level will be higher than a person who has taken very little portion of the Qur'an or nothing. ولذلك الإمام أبو داود الترمذي narrated من حديث عبد الله بن عمر بن عاص رضي الله تعالى عنهما and Sheikh Al-Albani رحمه الله authenticated it in his book السلسلة الصحيحة that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said يقال لصاحب القرآن, the person who had memorized the Qur'an will be said to them اقرأ وارتقي ورتل كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا فإن منزلتك عند آخر آية تقرأها. It will be said to the person who memorized the Qur'an, read, recite, and ascend. And it will be then said to them, you are going to be, yani, in Jannah, the last verse that you read. So if the person has memorized the whole entire Qur'an, he will be at the highest level. The fourth, inshallah ta'ala, benefit is that the person who memorizes the Qur'an can extract rulings from the Qur'an and the Sunnah if he has the understanding of it. يعني the Qur'an and the Sunnah, it's the masdar al-adilla. It's the foundation of where evidence is taken from, the Qur'an. And the ahkam, the jurisprudent rulings and the fatawa are taken from the Qur'an and the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So those are a few points I wanted to inshallah ta'ala bring to the attention of the questioner. Also now I want to move on to what the questioner asked, which is what are the things that can help a person to memorize the Qur'an? The first one is to show gratitude. We have to show gratitude to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala ala ni'mat al-hifz, for the virtue of memorization. The virtue of memorization. Memorization is a ni'mah min ni'amillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. It's a blessing from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if a person shows gratitude to that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only would he allow that memorization to remain for you, but he will increase it for you. As Allah says in Surah Ibrahim, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you show gratitude, Allah says, I will increase it for you. The second, inshallah ta'ala, quality and characteristics that the person should come with is ikhlas, sincerity. And ikhlas is what? إِخْلَاصُنَا لِلَّهِ صَفِّ الْقَلْبَ مِنْ إِرَادَةٍ سِوَاهُ فَحْدَرْ يَا فَطِنْ. Ikhlas means that your intent, your motive, your reasoning, your action are all for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. There is no one else you have in mind. It is Allah you want to do it for. And when it comes to the Qur'an, many people lack sincerity. Many people do. May Allah give us sincerity in everything that we say and do. And the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, in a hadith, al-Imam Ahmad narrated, من حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن عاص رضي الله تعالى عنهما and Sheikh Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani, he authenticated in his silsila al-sahiha that the Prophet said, أكثر منافقي أمتي قراؤها. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the largest quantity of hypocrites in my ummah are the reciters, the qurra. So the qurra have to make sure that when they learn the Qur'an, they do it for Allah's sake. And the person who memorizes the Qur'an should do it for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's sake. Also, what helps with the memorization of the Qur'an is the revision. You need to revise. And you have to تعاهد القرآن والإكثار من تلاوته ومراجعته. The person should recite the Qur'an a lot and go over it and over it. Because revision helps with keeping the information you've memorized. ولذلك the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in hadith Abi Musa al-Ash'ari, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, تَعَاهَدُوا الْقُرْآنَ أَمَا تَعَاهَدُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ. يعني revise this Qur'an. فَوَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٌ بِيَدِي لَهُوَ أَشَدُّ تَفَلُّتًا مِنَ الْإِبَدِي فِي عُقُلِهَا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that it escapes faster than a camel. فِي عُقُلِهَا. So memorize the Qur'an and revise it. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in another riwayah of Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, which is narrated in Bukhari and Muslim, innama mathalu sahib al-Qur'an, the Prophet said, ka mathali sahib al-ibil al-mu'allaqah, in aahada 'alayha amsakaha wa in atlaqaha dhahabat. So if a person tries to, you know, abandon reciting the Qur'an, they will forget it. How many of us have memorized the Qur'an and learned the Qur'an when we were young, but we forgot it when we got older because we stopped revising. If you stop revising, you forget the Qur'an. The fourth one is to stand up at night and pray with it. It's one of the ways that helps you. And يَقُومَ أَنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ وَأَنَاءَ النَّهَارِ. The person stands up day and night. يعني nighttime you pray with it, قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ, and also daytime you pray your salah with it. And I know a brother, may Allah honor him, and shower his never-ending mercy onto him, he would يعني recite the Qur'an in every prayer of his from Baqarah to Nas. Not in one prayer, but every salah he would read a portion. If it be a page, half a page. And he would do it in that order. And every month he would try to finish the Qur'an in his 5 daily prayers. Every month. So that's a good idea. That's how he keeps it. And also at night he prays with it. And Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated min hadithi Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, la hasada illa fitnatayni. There is no envy except in two people. Rajulun atahu Allahu al-Qur'an, a person Allah gave them the Qur'an. Fahuwa yaqumu bihi ana al-layli wa ana al-nahar. And this person is reciting and is reading and is utilizing the Quran day and night. وَرَجُلٌ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا فَهُوَ يُنْفِقُهُ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ وَآنَاءَ النَّهَارِ. And the second person that we should be jealous of is a person Allah gave them wealth, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this person is giving that wealth for the sake of Allah. And this jealousy doesn't mean that we ask Allah to remove this blessing from the person, but it means we ask Allah to give it to us as well, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So reciting the Quran in your prayers, day and night time, reciting it, going over it, also helps you keep the memorization of the Quran. Number five is making yourself acquainted with the meaning and the understanding that is in the verses. If you know the meaning, it will help you. Tafsir of the Quran. And it doesn't always have to be a detailed explanation. It doesn't have to be. Even if it's just something very basic about the verse, learn every verse something about it, even if it's small. And that would help you. Last but not least is to stay away from al-ma'asi wal-a'tham. Stay away from sins. And also stay away from what? Wal-khilta ma'al-ashrar. Mixing with evil people. Because when you mix with those people, they will affect your Qur'an and they will affect your memorization of the Qur'an. And I want to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Wal-ilmu indallahi. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
If you have any questions you'd like to see answered as part of this series, then you can email us at questions@amau.org.